listening to an audio article by the Common Constitution. Today's audio article is entitled, Just Get Vaccinated and You Can Keep Your Rights. And if you don't, well, we're not ready to discuss that. Not yet, anyway. Just last week, my WorldNet Daily article was about how America is sliding toward despotism. In it, I quoted a pretty smart guy by the name of Benjamin Franklin. You may have heard of him. No doubt, at least a few who read it rolled their eyes, thinking this is just more hyperbole from the common conspiracist. Here's old Ben's quote. Quote, I think a general government necessary for us, and there is no form of government but that may be a blessing to the people if well administered, and believe farther that this is likely to be well administered for a course of years and can only end in despotism, as other forms have done before it, when the people shall become so corrupted as to need despotic government, being incapable of any other, unquote. Benjamin Franklin, September 17, 1787. Well, we have obviously not heeded the words of men like Franklin, who were more learned and prescient than almost anyone in history since. And then I read this article at the Blaze/Conservative Review from just a couple of days ago. They wrote, quote, CNN medical analyst and former president of Planned Parenthood, Dr. Lena Wen, warned the Biden administration that it has a very narrow window for inoculating as many people as possible to COVID-19 as states begin lifting coronavirus restrictions, urging that messaging should tie vaccinations to Americans' freedoms. Well, holy crap. Get a vaccine or we'll curtail or revoke your freedoms? Is she kidding? Sadly, no. She is the opposite of kidding. In fact, Wen continued, quote, if you are vaccinated, you can do all these things. Here are all the freedoms that you have. Because otherwise, people are going to go out and enjoy these freedoms anyway, unquote. Now, this leaves a quite powerful yet unspoken follow-up statement, does it not? If you don't get the vaccine, here are the freedoms you won't get back or will take from you. Still think I and others are whacked out conspiracy theorists? Think Franklin didn't call it, like right on the money? This is what the anti-federalists like George Mason and Eldridge Gerry were afraid would happen. This is why they insisted that the Federalists like James Madison include in the Constitution a Declaration of Rights, which became our Bill of Rights, the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. They knew what Franklin knew, that America had to be unique if it were to stave off despotism. They knew that we needed a set of natural rights that were not granted to us by government, for anything granted to the people by government can be changed, abridged, or revoked altogether. And this, more than anything else, makes America unique, sets us apart and above every other nation in history. Every other nation, even the ones who have constitutions, have no set of natural God-given rights. All other nations have rights which were granted to them by governments, and thus can be taken away as easily as they were granted. And Dr. Wen is not a nobody without influence. She is a hard leftist that, as former president of Abortion Inc. and now analyst at CNN, likely has a direct line to Democrat leadership and the White House. And you can bet your last dollar that leftists in Washington are hard at work trying to find a way around those problematic natural rights. Thank you for listening.